and thank you for coming to Dying Potter Yoga. I'm Dying Potter. If you're here for the first time, if you're coming back, thank you so much. It's an honor. Today, we are doing back pain, day one of back pain, specifically day one. And if you're feeling a lot of pain in your lower back, I'm right here with you. So today, we'll need a few things. Block of ice. I have a pretty large block of ice. And a towel to secure it to my body, just to make it feel better. And we'll be using that. Also, I have a chair. I think it's really, really important at this stage of the game. Really, really, really slow. And lots of hip flexor love, because that's sometimes connected to the low back. Slow rest. Long, long holds. I think that's always worked for me, and I'm hoping that you also find relief today. Let's just start by grounding first. Sitting on all your feet. Your heels could just go right in to around the sitting bones. Another 5 breaths to relax and ground. Child's pose. You can do this with bolster, or you can do this with your legs together to really, if you can put your legs together, it kind of helps your lower back to be it helps the lower back. If the legs are together, it rounds your back out a little bit. Feel free if you want to grab a pillow, put it between your legs. I'm going to rest the ice on my back like this. You know what? I think that I'm going to need a pillow first. Do not consider that. Pillow between my legs. You can use blocks, pillows, bolster, or you can use both. You can set the blocks up. Pillow on top of the blocks. And put the ice right on top of your back. Taking the towel. Underneath it. You can also bring your arms around and hold, press. Like bring your hands together to kind of help release the back a little bit. What that's doing is like pulling your backs gently away. Your hips away from your back with resting the ice right on your lower back. Breathe. Thank you. opposite direction of your face. Lie on one side of your face. Lie another. Next bow, we'll switch positions. Very slowly, we're going to just roll to one side of the legs. Legs around. I'm holding the ice in my back still. The legs probably want to be straight right now. Straighten out. I'm actually going to keep my legs straight like this. And I'm going to keep kind of my blocks on the pillow where they are. I'm just going to fold over. If I can. Maybe put one block right underneath, one block. Where did it go? Okay, slowly. One block behind my back. Maybe I could get rid of the towel for now and put the ice block right, holding it straight up. If I don't feel that, I'm going to move it. I'm going to move it to my back, and I'm still going to use the block for support. I think that I just need to rest the block, the ice on the block. Mindless, nice and slow. The elbows, and then push your hands into the ground. Bring the pillow and the block in front of you. I'm gonna lie down actually on my back with the feet up on the chair. So I'm gonna put my chair on the mat very slowly. Using my arms a lot because that's how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna use my arms a lot for this transaction. I want the chair on the yoga mat. And I would like to have the block underneath me now. This block is going to go right underneath my back. Yes. Yeah, I think I need a towel for that. Like kind of put it right onto your back, so when you sit on it, just sit on the block of ice. Feet up, slowly lower yourself down. Your hips are just slightly elevated because the block of ice is underneath your sacrum. This is going to be a long rest. I think rest here as long as you need. It's really about taking it easy today on day one of back pain. Feel that your hip flexors are inflamed. It's okay. Maybe you want to lose the ice on your back and put it right on your hip flexors. You probably only get one at a time, but that's still, you can get the other side in a minute. Thank you. going to again slip this block of ice under my seat. So you stay as long as that's feeling like it's working, stay there. If it's still under your seat, still working there, you can stay there too. I'm gonna roll to one side to slip it under my seat. Layer up my toes there. If you are using a ball for this, you might need crossing your ankles will help take some of the pressure off your back, so you're just not at all using your back. The easiest, if you cross your legs without any discomfort at all, the leg on top is probably not where the pain is coming from. But if you need to switch the leg crossing, which you might, should probably do in a little bit, and if you feel anything there on your left side, you'll know that that's where it's coming from. That's what happened to me this morning. I used a ball. I would, you know, suggest doing this a few times. And if your back is out, it's about rest. It's about nurture, self-care, and healing. The universe might just be sending a message to slow down. To scoot the ice down under my tailbone, which is the bone between your butt cheeks. I need to do that. I'm gonna put that block back on my hip flexors. If my back is still in this shape tomorrow, I'll do the same thing with more ice. So I can have one under my tailbone and one on my hip flexors, or two on my hip flexors maybe. Because it does really feel like my hip flexors are kind of a little bit responsive. Now to get out, you're going very, very slowly because we need to. One leg.
time.
So you can maybe bring your knees in towards your chest. Rock to one side, whichever side feels more accessible. So if you want to linger there, a little twist. Take both arms over. Then use your arms to press into a seat slowly. May the rest of your day unfold with grace. Namaste. Bye.